Shalom Abracha, good morning, a good tovach, and a gezuntavach shavua tov to lechoshav olam, ahuvai v'rei'ai. Welcome back, post-Chanukah, hoping that everyone enjoyed a freilich and lichtig and Chanukah. Let's start by thanking our weekly sponsors, once again, the extended family of Sophie Freeland, all the Divrei Torah, all the Shurim this week, in memory of Chaya Shosha Feiga Bas Yisrael Nochem Alah Shalom, Tizka Limitzis, the Kota Salad, Hei Ligin Hashem, Shmizachadu, tremendous and continuous Aliyas and Hashema, and Gan Eden Shalom. So with Siyata Deshmaya, let's turn our attention to the very outset of this week's Parsha, Parshas Vayigash, and what a powerful Parsha it is. So it starts with Vayigash Elav Yehuda. We were left off last week with a major cliffhanger. Yehuda and Yosef in the middle of a discussion and smack in the middle of the dialogue of this poignant conversation. All of a sudden, the Torah Kedosha leaves us hanging. And then what? Vayigash Elav Yehuda. Why? Ah, Lefiyani Yastaiti, it's Poshit. Because Yehuda, we know, after the Maisa Yehuda and Tamar, and after the whole Maisa with Yosef Atzadik and selling him, they were Morid Yehuda from his godless. He lost his lofty status as the Melech. But now what? Now he's ready to step up to the plate. Who is Anochi Arvenu? Puts his Olam Hazes, Olam Haba on the line. That's what Yaakovina saw. And now Yosef witnesses as well. Yehuda is ready to put it all on the line. Bimosa Nefesh for his brother, and not only that, Yehuda, the Melech of all the Shvatim, but the Melech Befrat of the Bnei Leah, and now putting it all on the line for Binyamin, the son of Rochel, that Tikkun, that's Malchus. This is a different Yehuda that emerges onto the world stage. The Torah giving us a subtle hint, a subtle allusion to that. We met with one Yehuda at the end of Parshas Miketz, the Fiyani Yastaiti. What a great place to break off in the middle of the conversation. Why? Because at this moment, Vayigash Sheil of Yehuda, now we approached as Yehuda. Yehuda the Melech. This is when Yehuda has now already started the return to what we're going to read about in next week's Parshas Vayechi. Yehuda Ati Yaducha Chicha Avram of Yaakov Avino stamps him with the eternal title of Yehuda. He's going to be Malchus Beis David. He's going to be the Shoresh, the source, the seed of that Malchus. And it all starts right here. Vayigash Elav Yehuda. This is Yehuda the Melech. And not only that, fascinating Medrash Rabbah here in Parsha Tzadi Gimel and Oz Zayin. Yehuda, Agur Aryeh Yehuda, the one who's likened to the lion. When is he now? Like, we didn't even get to the Brucha yet. That's going to be in next week's Parsha. State the Medrash. No, Yehuda ready now. Stood up to Yosef, the viceroy. Unbeknownst to him, it was Yosef. But he roars like the lion, Shinemar, because it says about him, Gur Aryeh Yehuda. He is Mamush the lion. He is the lion, the king in the jungle, right? It's the Vilna Gaon in Mishlei. Aperchokes, the lion's roar. That signals to all the animals in the kingdom. He alone is the king of the jungle. In fact, the roar of a lion could spread for miles away. Causes all the animals to freeze in their tracks. That's the Aryeh. That is the Mazel of Chodesh Nisan, Rosh Lechotche Hashanah. That's Chodesh Aviv, Av Liyur Beis Chotche Hashanah, Ayin B'nei Yisosu, Der Pikudech HaBashas Pikudei. That's the Chodesh Ha'ovim, Av L'Yir Beis Chodesh Hashanah, that's Nisan, that's the Mazel Aryeh, that's the king in the jungle. This is Yehuda the king, and he roars like the lion, and approaches Yosef and says, here I am, representative of the Shvatim, I'm the king of the jungle, and writes the Medrash, that when Yehuda screamed out, and he roared like a lion, on the fascinating Ramazim in the Medrash about Mamish, he burst forward, he had unbelievable strength, and the roar of the lion went all the way back to Eretz Canaan, and who heard the roar? Chushim ben Don. Now let's keep in mind, Sota Dafyud Gimel Manal of Chushim ben Don, who was deaf, heard the roar of the lion, even though he was deaf, he was able to, he had that extra frequency, or the roar was so loud, it penetrated all the way to Eretz Canaan. State the Medrash Rabbah, Tzadi Gimel Zayin. Chushim hears that roar. Now remember, Chushim is the son of Dan. We'll see that later on in the parsha. Mem Vav Chav Gimel Vnei Dan Chushim, one of the shortest psukim, all but 10 letters, and all the Chumash, the one lone son of Dan, was Chushim. Chushim was deaf. As Chazal relates, Sota Yud Gimel, he heard the roar of Yehuda. Yehuda Gur Aryeh, and Gur Aryeh Yehuda, Dan Gur Aryeh, Dan Gur Aryeh. We'll see Moshe Rabbeinu in his bracha Hashiva Dan. Later on, at the very end of the Torah parsha, is also bracha. Two out of the 12 Shvatim likened to the lion. Yehuda is Gur Aryeh Yehuda. And then we have Don Gor Aryeh, order reversed, because Yehuda is first and foremost the lion. Don Gor Aryeh, but he's what? He's the tail of the lion. Yehuda travels in the journey throughout the desert. Yehuda's number one. He's in front. He's the melech. He's the manig. And who's at the back? Don. Pasigin ba'loischa per gyur pasuch hafei. Don Shevet Don is the ma'aseh for the kol ha'machanos. He's at the back. Kol ha'necha sholem acharecha, the one who gets attacked by Amalek. He's the one who collects all the avedas and all the lost souls, brings them all back. He is the tail of the lion. He is Don Gor Aryeh. So listen to this medrash. Vayigash Eilav Yehuda. He approaches Yosef. He roars like a lion. And Chushim Adon, who is back with Yaakov, his Zaydi in Eretz Canaan, miraculously comes down right away to the land of Egypt. How did he get there? Manas Kuna says he was unbelievably fast. But the Perushim on Merah said that he was Maske, one of the Shemus HaKadoshim. You could use one of the holy names of God for Kvitzas HaDerech to curtail one's journey. And he got down miraculously, either miraculous speed, or it was miraculous Alpi Shemus HaKadoshim, and he joins the two lions, right? The Merah are now standing alongside, and they were ready to topple all the Mitzrayim until Yosef had to show his strength, and then they backed down a little bit, and then we continue with the ensuing dialogue. But here he had the two lions in Yehuda and Chushim. These two lions were ready to tackle and topple all the land of Egypt. Remember, the mightiest, strongest nation in that day and age. So let me ask you, everybody, say, how do you understand the matter? Yehuda now is saying, Yosef, don't mess with the Shvatim. Don't mess with me and don't play games with us. In the end of the day, if this is what it comes down to, then Chushim and I, the two lions, the head of the lion, the tail of the lion, we alone will topple all of the Egypt. And Menorah says, that's what he hinted to Yosef. We're ready to destroy you and destroy your entire land if that's what it comes down to. Yehuda, what are you doing turning to Chushim? Why did Yehuda have to turn to Chushim and Don? Why doesn't he turn to Shimon and Levi? Shimon and Levi, after all, they alone together, you see the might of the Shiftei Kah, and you see Befrat Shimon and Levi, they alone toppled the entire city of Shechem. Yes, they got them on Yom Shlishi Lemilos on the third day after the circumcision, but at the end of the day, Shimon and Levi, these are strong people. Take a Shimon, take a Levi. Taking Chushim and Don, what are you doing taking a Chushim and Don? Why did he, Dafka, join forces with Chushim, and that was the combined threat to topple the land of Egypt? Phineas Deity, perhaps, and a more profound understanding of what's going on behind the scene is as follows. Let's first understand what Chazal tell us when they tell us throughout the many Midrashim, Medrash Rabbah, Medrash Tanchuma, the Yad Kachemoni, and we have the Gemara Bava Basra, Kuf Chav Gimel and Beis, Einis of Nofel, Ela Biyad Banel Shel Rachel. We know that when Yosef HaTzadik was born back in Parshas Vayetze, Rashi told us based on the Medrash, when Yosef was born, that's when Yaakov said it's time to go home. No, let's sit, no, Shel Esav. We have the arch rival, the arch nemesis, the adversary of Esav. We're ready to go back home. We could take on an Esav. But the choice terminology of Chazal is that Ein Esav Nofel Ela Biyad Banel Shel Rachel. Biyad Banel. Now the Fiyani is the idea. Biyad Banel doesn't say Dafke Bnei Yosef. So Biyad Banel Shel Rachel. That means Esav's going to fall through the hands of the Bonim of Rachel. Now remember, Rachel had two biological children. With her union with Yaakov, they produced Yosef and of course Binyamin. But she also had two Bonim Chitzainim. Remember, she had two children, Dan and Naphtali, who were born to her. Ayadei Bila, the Shivcha, the maidservant that she bought into the marriage. The Maisa, she had four children. The Phineas Deity, let's take a step back and analyze what takes place. We have to battle Esav of Russia throughout history. Well, the Chayra, there are two battles occurring simultaneously. There's the physical battle against Esav, Eliphaz, Amalek, and then there's the spiritual battle against the Pnimius of all the depravity and perversity and corruption and immorality that Esav and his descendants represent. Who is going to battle the Pnimius, which is always the Iker Koach? The Iker Machlekes is the spiritual battle. Who's going to wage war against the Pnimius of Esav? That's going to be Yosef HaTzadik. He's the one to tackle the Pnimius of Esav. Nolad Esav, Nolad Pnimius of Esav, Nolad the Sinol Shel Esav. And the Pnimius, I don't have to go ahead and worry, because I got Yosef HaTzadik. And as the Maharal of Prague explains in his Or Chodesh and several other places, when we don't have a worthy candidate from Shevet Yosef, then we'll have someone from Shevet Binyamin who will rise to the occasion. Hence the Purim story. You have Haman, a descendant of Amalek. Who's going to topple Amalek? So who is given the first charge to destroy Agag, Melech Amalek? Who is that Shaul? Shaul Amalek came from Shevet Binyamin because he was the most worthy person to be king at the time. That's Shevet Binyamin. And when there's no one worthy from Shevet Yosef. Who are we going to have? Mordechai Ben Kish Ishyamini from Sheva Ben Yamin. Mordechai and Esther came from Sheva Ben Yamin, and they're going to topple the Haman. So if you have no one from Sheva Ben Yosef, sometimes it'll be what? The end of Bashalach, Perk Yitzayin. Vayachlosh Yoshua, Samolik Yoshua, a grandson of Ephraim, a descendant of Ephraim, who came as a son of Yosef, will be the one to target. But if you don't have a worthy person to represent Klai Yisrael from Sheva Ben Yosef, then as the Maral and others explain, it'll be someone from Sheva Ben Yamin, and Shola Melech, charged with killing Agag, and then you have Mordechai and Esther from Sheva Ben Yamin. So they're going to tackle the Iker, the Pnimiyus Dikamachoma against an ace of a Rasha. But tomorrow for a Baisai, we have to deal with the Gashmiyus Dikakoach, the physical battle. Who killed Esav? Let's go to Sota, Nafyud Gimel Manalev, towards the end of the first parak of Masechta Sota. And we know that there's a fascinating dialogue going on. Yaakov Avinu's body is ready to be interred in Marsuach Pailin, the cave of the patriarchs. And Esav boldly, brazenly stands at the entrance way and says, I'm not letting him in. And what happens is an ensuing commotion, and Chushim, who is deaf, famous for Chaim Shmulevitz, peace and Sichas Musar, only someone who's deaf, he has no negias. He's not busy, I don't want to get, don't engage Esav in discussion. Esav's doing something corrupt, something wrong. What does he do? He takes a staff, he takes a club, smacks Esav on the back of his head, the eyes pop out, the head rolls off, and it rolls into Chekel Shel. Yitzchak and Esav is done with. Or again, parenthetically, we have to deal with Tosis and Gittin, Adaf and Haman Bey, based on the Yashami and Ksuvis as well, that Yehuda is the one who killed Esav. So Tosis says, Zevzeh Gorim, Dainu Chushim, started the process, Yehuda finished it off. So that's already great scene, great idea of what you see, Chushim and Yehuda joining forces. Chushim gives the bang on the back of Esav's head. He debilitated him. He didn't fully kill him, writes Tosis. And then Yehuda was the Makkah of Apatish. Yehuda finished the job. Again, the might of Chushim and Yehuda. But what do we see? Chushim is the one who physically killed an Esav. Gevaldik, that's Chushim one, the lone son and thus representative of all the Sheva Dan, Uvnei Dan Chushim. And then we have what? Let's go back to that story in Sota Daf Yud Gimel. What happens? Esav says, the last spot of Masmah Pela, that belongs to me. Aye, they send Naphtali back to Mitzrayim to procure the deed that highlights and reinforces, no, Yaakov purchased, this belongs to Yaakov. Naphtali gets praised by none other than Yaakov in next week's Parsha Naphtali. Totally, Ayala Shlucha, like into the fast hind. What do we say? Nishmas, Raglenu Kalos Ka'ayalos. Ah, quick, like the hind, even though the cheetah is the fastest land mammal, can reach speeds up to 71 miles an hour. Aye, but fast like the hind, aye, but the deer and the antelope and the hind, these animals, these creatures, they're much quicker. Naftoli, Ayala Shlucha, no sinemre shefer. As I'll say, he's a reference when he ran back to the land of Egypt ever so quickly to procure the deed. Givaldig Naphtali shows the deed. It's Yaakov's body, who is the only body worthy of being interred in Masmach Pailah. And Chushim and Don does away with Esav. So what glorious picture emerges, my dear friends? Yosef and Binyamin are there to tackle the Pnimius and the Iker of what Esav represents in this world and what Amalek represents in this world. No, let's sit no shall Esav. Mordechai, Esther, it's not about killing Haman and all his descendants as much as it's about getting rid of their pernicious, harmful influence in the world. And that's Sholem El, get rid of the Koach of Amalek in the world. That's Yosef, that's Binyamin. But who's there to tackle the physical to destroy Esav? It was Chush, the son of Dan, who killed Esav. It was Naphtali who guaranteed through his miraculous speed that Esav's body will not be in the last place of Masmach Pela. That'll be only for the body of his grandfather Yaakov Avinu. Now, what do we have? Let's go back to that Chazal. The choice wording was Enes of Nofil, Ela Biyad Banel Sherachel Afinias Daiti, the collective four sons, not just two, the collective four sons of Rachel, the Hainu. She had Bonim Pnimiim, the biological children that she gave birth to, the Hainu, Yosef and Binyamin Mitzan Echad. And then Rabbi Isai, you have the Bonim Chitzainiim, who were born to her, that she begot in a Chitzainiistika Ofen, in an external fashion, Ayadeh, her external maidservant, Bilhah. She produces a Dan and a Naphtali. So she has four sons. It's Gevaldik. The Chitzoni is Dikabon and born in an Eifa and Chitzoni. And they're to tackle and address the Chitzoni is Dikachelik of Esav. And they do a great job. Chushim, the son of Dan, kills the Chitzoni of Esav. Naphtali disallows the Chitzoni, the body, from getting interred. Ivan the Bon and Pnimiim, Yosef and Binyamin. They're going to be the ones, Ledori Doros, who will always tackle the essence, the Pnimius of the Rishus, the wickedness that Esav and Amalek represent in the world. But Rabbi say it gets even better than that. Let's be mamshich the kavala. Let's develop it a little bit more. What do we know about Chushim? Chushim is the only one And a Chumash besides Naphtali, who is known to possess miraculous speed. Naphtali, remember, is Mamish, he's the predecessor for Lahavdil Flash, the superhero. He can make it down to Mitzrayim, get the deed, and he's back Mamish in a moment. Miraculous speed. And what do we know about Chushim? Let's go to the Targum Yonasim Nazio. Uvnei Dan Chushim writes the Targum Yonasim. The sons of Dan, Zrizin, Viampurin. They was Zrizin, right? The Perish Yonasim. They were what? The Targum of Chushim is Mehirus and Zrizus. Fast, like we have in Matos, Venetzo Chushim. Chushim is quick, is speed. Givaldik. The only two people in all of Chumash who were singled out to possess miraculous speed. Chushim, Manas Kuna says, going back to the Medrash with which we started today, how in the world did he get down from Eretz Canaan to Mitzrayim so quickly? He also possessed miraculous speed. So Rabbi say, what emerges? Two people have miraculous speed. Chushim, Mitzan Echad, and Naphtali, Mitzan Sheni. Now, where is speed? Speed is what? Is all in the koch or aglayim. Where's the source of the koch of speed? People who could run quickly, where is that in the aglayim? Why would Hashem do that? Lefianias daiti, it's geshmak. Why? Because Esav only was able to be pogeya. He was only able to attack Malach Shel Esav. Sorah Shel Esav, the koch hasam, was only able to get Yaakov in what area? Let's go back to Vayishlach, Vayiga Bekaf Yerecho. He was only able to inflict damage in the chelek hachitzoni, in the body, the physical aspect of Yaakov. The koch of Esav was able to inflict damage where? In one part and one part only. And where is that in the regel? Who's going to be masaking that? The mida kenegan mida. Who's going to get back at Esav b'ofen chitzoni? Adak lefiyani astaiti, the bonim chitzoniim of Ruchel, born al yaday, bila, b'ofen chitzoni. Chushim is going to do what? Is going to use his speed. He's going to come down. Ultimately, he's down in Mitzrayim. And ultimately, he's going to be the one who's going to do away with Esav, the body of Esav. And Naphtali's going to use his speed to go down and disallow the corpse, the body of Esav, to be interred. The two people to do away with the chitzoniistic aspect of Esav are the bonim chitzonium of Ruchel. And they'll address the chelika chitzoni. The two and only two people in all of Chumash who are known to possess miraculous speed. Kevalik, the Chitzonius and the Pinimius. That's Yosef and Binyamin. So, my dear friends, now we understand the choice terminology. Enesim Nofil, Ela Biyad Baneha. All the collected bottom. Let's go to Vajra Perk Alapos Yurches. Be'es Yosef. Beis Yaakov Lakash, Beis Yosef Lahava, and Beis Esav Lakash. How are you going to burn up the koch of Esav in the world? Ayadeh Yaakov, he's going to start the process, but you need Yosef. Ain Esav, no fellow be Abanel Shel, you need Yosef, the Nolatzin of Shel Esav. But what is Yosef called metaphorically? He's called the Lahava. Lam and Hey, Beis, Hey, Lefini Estaiti, intermingle the letters ever so slightly, and what do you get? Bilha, Bilha, Dahainu, it's not just Yosef, it's Yosef with the combined efforts of Beis Yosef Lahava. You have to join to Yosef Lahava Bilha, the B'nai Bilha. He can only do it when he's joined with Chushim and when he's joined with Naphtali. That's how you get rid of the cost. And now let's get back to the original question. What's he doing going to Chushim? So let's go to the Shlach Kaddish. The Shlach says, this week's parasha, the way Abishter set up, you need a Mashiach ben Yosef before you can have a Mashiach ben David. You need Yosef. What's Yosef? Right? Thor Gedalio, the koch of Asifa, the koch of gathering together. It's Yosef who gathers together and consolidates the Shvatim. Before Mashiach ben David, before Yehuda can ascend his rightful place on the eternal throne of the Davidic dynasty, you need a descendant of Yosef, Mashiach ben Yosef, to have a koch Asifa to bring everybody together, and then you can have the Melech. The same way you need Aaron and Cohen being the Holy Shomron Shalom, and then you can have Moshe Rabbeinu be the leader. You need, writes the Shlach, Mashiach ben Yosef to bring everyone together, and then you can have Yehuda. Mela writes the Shlach. Yosef now succeeded in this week's parasha. Vayigash, everyone is coming together. Gevalik, Vayigash, the approach. They're coming together, and they're going to come together where? In the land of Goshen. HaGoshen, they're all going to come together. Yosef put them together. When is Yosef ready to step down? And now let Yehuda take over. Vayigash, I love Yehuda. Now when Yehuda presents himself as the Melech, as the lion, as the king of the jungles, Yehuda Gorarye, Yosef is ready to step down. See, he already did his job. Now Yehuda says, if I'm going to be the Melech of Yehuda, I need a koch of Yosef. Remember, he doesn't know it's Yosef right now. He needs someone who can help bring everybody together. Who's going to bring everyone together? I don't have Yosef. Because Yosef HaTzadik right now, as far as they know, he's off the map. Right, what about Binyamin? I got to go ahead and deal with evil. How do you deal with evil? You need someone who can deal with the forces of evil. It's got to be a Yosef. It's got to be a Binyamin. Well, I don't have Yosef and Binyamin right now. He's incarcerated, right? He's in this. I don't have Binyamin. Where else he's going to go? I have to go to the Chitzainis, the Kechelek of the Bnei Bila. I have to go to Fini Estaiti, my humble opinion. He goes Davkin on Chushim. What is Chushim, the son of Don? What do we know about Don? Hama'asef l'kol ha'machano. Sheva Don is the koch ha'sifa. They bring everybody together. Yehuda's the head of the lion, but the tail of the lion brings everybody together. If I don't have Yosef, koch ha'sifa mamish, pshuto kimashmo. And I don't have Binyamin, Mordechai, like kenosis kol Yehudim, but also yachat techeles Mordechai. If I don't have that koch hasifa, where am I going to get it? I have to go to a son of Bilah. I'm going to go to Bnei Dan Chushim. And he gets it from Dan, the Maasev of the Kol HaMachlis, who embodied and personified all of Dan, his one single son of Bnei Dan Chushim. And now he's got Chushim by his side. Yehuda is Malchus Yehuda with Chushim, the koch of hasifa, who's bringing the koch of us all spiritually, metaphysically together. Now I got the head of the lion, the tail of the lion. I have the koch encircling all the koch of all the shifte koch. These two people, Yehuda and Chushim. I got the koch of everybody together. I have the koch of Asifa. Now I have the koch of Malchus. Vayigash Elav Yehuda. Now he's ready to step forward and ready him and Chushim, the head and tail of the lion, all the koch of the Ari, the king in the jungle, ready to take over Yosef. And now we understand the Medrash, my friends, have a glorious geshmaka, Leibedika Torah filled day up ahead.